Hi, I'm Helle. Today I will take a look at how to play Azul, Stained Glass of Sintra. And here we have the new version of Azul. We have these tiles that could look like candy. They have very bright colors, but it's not, so don't try to eat them. Let's take a look at how to set up the game. Each player will choose a color and the corresponding palace board. And for your first game, make sure it starts with this side A up. There's also a side B, and the end scoring will be a little bit different on this side. And each player will get a glacier and two cubes. And then you will have these 8 pattern strips. You will shuffle them, mix them together, and place them to your palace. And now this player's board is finished. There are 8 of these pattern strips, and there are 5 different colors. We also have one strip that has these 2 black place spaces on them. You can place 5 tiles to these, and these are joker tiles, so you can place any color here. You may not start with this side up at the start of the game, so you have to turn this one over and place it again to your board. Also notice on top of the board you can see what's on the other side. So you know when you finish this pattern strip, you have to turn it around, so you know what that is on the other side of the pattern strip. If you are 2 players, you will use 5 of these factory tiles. And if one of you is colorblind, you can turn them all to this side. If you are 3 players, you will use 7 factories. And if you are 4 players, you will use all 9 factory tiles. Set aside a glass tile, 1 for each color. There are 5 different. And then put the rest in the bag. Now, shuffle the 5 glass in your hand and let them drop 1 by 1. And put them to the display like this. Then take the bag and draw 1 more cube. And place it here. There are 6 rounds in the game. Then each player will place 1 cube here on the broken glass track and on 0 points. Each player will take their little meeple and place them on the leftmost pattern strip, like this, at the top of it. And you will fill all the factories with 4 random drawn tiles. And you will give the start player marker to the person that last cleaned windows. Let's say it was the yellow player. This game is played over 6 rounds. And each round will end when there are no more tiles at the factory. In the first round, we can get bonus points if we finish any of these with the blue color in them. So if we manage to finish a pattern strip with blue, we can get extra points for this round for blue. On your turn, you can do 2 things. You can either choose tiles from this factory, or you can move your meeple to the leftmost pattern strip. At the start, you can't do that, because it already stands at the leftmost pattern strip. But later on, if your meeple was standing there, then you could take the action and move back instead of taking any tiles from the factory. And you always have to move back to the pattern strip that is the leftmost pattern strip. The start player will start his turn, placing this at the center, and he can now choose to draw tiles from one of the factories, and he has to take all of the same colors from that factory. And now we have blue will give extra points, so he might take these 2 blue tiles, and then you will put all the other tiles into the center. So you can either choose tiles from your factory, or you can also choose tiles from the center of the table. And if you take from the center, you also have to take all matching colors. If you are the first player, you will get the first player marker. And then you will have to go 1 step down on this track, where you will get minus points at the end of the game. But you will get to be the star player the next time. When you finish a pattern strip, you will score points. If you have any of the current round's color, you will score 1 point for each. So here we will score 3 points for these 3 blue colors. 1, 2, 3. And then you will choose 1 of them and place here on your palace board. And the rest you will discard in this glass tower, broken glass tower. When you have finished a pattern strip, you will turn it to the other side. And on the pattern strip, you can always see what's on the other side. So you will turn it over to the other side and place it back. The second time you will finish this pattern strip, it will be removed from the game. So you can score this pattern strip twice. You will build it on the one side and then the other side. And then you will score points. For this, you have finished 4 points. And if you had any that was filled, if, for example, let's say we already had made these, then we would get 4 points plus 2 plus 1. So that would have been 7 points. But in this case, we only have this one filled, so it will give us 4 points. It's actually best to kind of fill up the ones at the end, because when you would put more into it, you will get more points. You will always score everything that has been filled this way to the right from the pattern strip you are scoring. Now, this player has to take tiles. Could go down and fill this one out, even though he would receive double in the minus points. Maybe he would just go here to this spot and take these 4. Now he also has to take this, the first player marker, and he will go 1 down here. This player might choose to go back to this space, and then this player has to choose if he wants to finish this one. He could finish the next turn, then he would get 1 extra point, and this would also give him 1 minus point if he chose these 2. No, wait a minute, he will go here and take this blue tile. And this player will take these 2. Now, does he want to finish one and get more minus points? I think he will do it. I think he will go down here. He could leave them. On the other hand, it's 2 times minus. No, I don't think he will take them. He will go back here. This player can't go back. He has to choose these tiles. So I think he will go all the way down here. Lucky for him, he can use 5 of the tiles. So he would go like this. Put these 5 tiles in here. These 2 will be discarded, and he will go down twice on this for the broken glass, 1 for each. And then he will score this one. No bonus points, but he will get 2 points. And then these will be discarded, and he will turn this one around. And then we will remove this one. There are now 5 rounds back, and we will fill up the factories again. If you run out of tiles, you will take all the tiles from this glass tower and put into the bag. And the start player will start the game, and you will play in exactly the same way, where you can either move your meeple or you can draw tiles. Now, after the final round, we will go to the end scoring. And here we will look at the yellow player. The yellow player will receive minus 10 points, so from 70 to 60 points. And then we will count how many tiles they have on their pattern strips, so up here. This player has 7, for each 3 you have, you will get 1 point. So 3, so 7 times 3 is 2, so this player will get 2 points. And then we will look at our palace board. And for each we have surrounded of these, with 1 or 0, we will get nothing. If we have 2 tiles, we will get 3 points. 3 tiles will give us 6 points, and all 4 would give us 10 points. This one we have surrounded entirely, so this will give us 10 points. This is worth nothing. This one will give us 6 points, and this one will give us 6 points. If there had only been 2 here, it would have been 3 points instead. But here we will get 10 plus 12, 22 points. So 1, 2, and we will jump up to 84 points. So this would be the yellow player's points for this game. And the player that receives the most points is the winner of the game. If there is a tie for the winning player, then you will look at who has the least minus points at this track. So that would have been the blue player. If they both were tied here too, then they would share victory. If you had played with this side, the B side, then you will count how many you have finished, where you have finished both of the patterns. So here would be 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you will count how many you have of one color on the board, how many tiles you have. And here we also have 1, 2, 3, 4. So your score here would be 4 times 4. It would have been 16 points. If you had managed to get one more yellow, it would have been 4 times 5. Then it would have been 20 points. Now I will play just one more round so you can get a better feeling for the game. I think the orange player will go over here to finish this line. And you will take this one over here. And this will give one extra point. And we will choose a red. And that will give 3 points. This, and we will turn this one around. And the blue player, there aren't many yellows, but he would really like 2 yellows, because he would like to score them this round. So I think he will just go back here. And this player, I think this player will move over here and take these 3. And this player would like 1 of these. Oh, that player would have wanted that one. And then, does he want to take a minus to finish this one? Or may he have other plans then? Yeah, I think he will take this one. Move these 2 down here. And he will get 1 minus. He will score this, there aren't any bonus. So he will just choose 1 to place. And it will give him 2 points. And this will be turned around. This player will take the start marker and go down and take these 2 yellows. Because they will score extra points. So they will score 4 points plus 4, 8, 9, 10, 11 points. So, like that. And he will keep a yellow. Turn this one around. And here we have some joker tiles. I think he will wait with this. He wants to build more down here before he will make this one. I think this player will move over here and take these 4 orange tiles. And what does he want to do? He can't make this one. He cannot finish. He cannot finish that one. I don't think he has anything that he would be able to finish in this round. So he might look at the colors, that one. Yeah, I think he will just go down to this one and take these 2. Does he want 1 more minus point? Or will he wait? I think he will wait and take these 2. Just so he can tease this player just a little bit. I think he will go back. And this player can move over here and take these 2. I think he will just go over here and take the 2 blues here then. So he can start on this one. And this player can take the white. And he could move over here and take these 2 orange. At some point when we finish one more, we will remove this pattern strip. And I will end here. I hope you have got a good feeling of how the game is played. Thanks for watching.